Hello everyone. In previous class we have done a problem related to assembly of sleeve and quarter. Assembly of sleeve and quarter from pictorial view. In today's class let's try to draw disassembled view of the same combination. It means for today's class the task is to draw details or disassembled view of the same combination. Disassembled view or details of different parts separately. So let's see how to draw disassembly of sleeve and quarter for the same combination. So the problem statement is, the figure given below shows the assembly of a sleeve and quarter joint. Disassemble the following parts and draw the following views to full size scale. First, front elevation of the sleeve and side elevation viewing from left. Second, front elevation of rod A and rod B and side elevation viewing from the left. Third, front elevation of quarter in vertical position and the plan. Plan means top view. Then print titles and scale used, draw the projection symbol and give 8 important dimensions. As you can see, this is the front view full in section, assembled front view of sleeve and quarter joint, full in section and side view. And different dimensions are for sleeve 90 plus 90, total length 180. Then outer diameter of sleeve in the side view, it is dia 66, internal dia 30. Then for quarter slot, the distance is 30 from extreme right and from extreme left. Then for the second end of the quarter slot we have to calculate. And then for rod, dia is 24 on extreme ends. Then in the middle portion under the sleeve, dia is equals to 30 and the length is 90 plus 10, additional 10 on the ends. So 90 plus 10, 100, 90 plus 10, 100. And in the central plane, 4 is mentioned. So 4 means that length, total length is 4. Now for quarter, upper width 32, lower width 28. And total length 50 plus 50, 100. And thickness of quarter, 8. So these are all related dimensions of the assembled view or of different parts of this assembly. Now, our task is first to draw for sleeve, front view and side view from the left. So we will start from sleeve. Then we have rod A. Then we have rod A and rod B. And third, quarter. So first, sleeve. So for the sleeve, the total dimension means total length, which is given to us, is 90 plus 90, 180. So for quarter, first of all, draw 90 plus 90, 180. And if you know which lines or which edges are dark visible edges, you can start with dark pencil also. So the diameter is 66, outer diameter is 66 and internal dia is 33. So draw a rectangle. Initially it's a rectangle, so draw a rectangle of size 66 vertically and horizontally for 90 plus 90, 180. So the length is 180. Approximately 180, yes, this is 180. Okay, so external dia 66. Internal dia is 30. And before that, from its midpoint or central axis, draw axis of the sleeve and extend it for the side view. Like this. Okay, So this is the external dia. Now for internal dia, dia is 30, so 15 up and 15 down. From this point, 15 up and 15 down. So 15 up and 15 down, hidden, because internal part or internal cylindrical portion of the sleeve is not visible from the front. So draw hidden line. Throughout its length. Right. So this is the external dia and this is internal dia of the sleeve 66 and 30. Right. Then quarter slot. Now for quarter slot. Quarter slot means cavity on the sleeve. The distance from extreme right and extreme left is 30. So from this end, the distance is 30. So 30 from left, 30 from left, hidden. Again, from extreme right, the distance is 30. So 30 from right, 30 from right on the sleeve. Right. Now, what is the width? What is the width of quarter slot? This width is missing. So we have to calculate. Again, we have two methods, two options, two choices to mark cavity or slot. First is from the central width and second is using dimensions of quarter. So this we can discuss after drawing of quarter. Now, side view of the sleeve. So for side view of the sleeve, please project or extend limits of sleeve. Side view from left means on the right side, and then draw excess of the sleeve, excess or center line. Now this is the excess and this is the front view. So for its side view, we have to draw two circles of dia 30 and dia 66. First circle of dia 30 mm, and second circle of dia 66. And in the side view, quarter slot thickness is 8, equals to the thickness of quarter. So from the central line, 4 left, 4 right, hidden. 4 left, 4 right, and hidden. Okay, then next is rod A and rod B. So for both the rods, diameter is 30 and 24. So extended diameter 30 and core diameter on the ends is 24. So again draw excess for both the rods. Like this. And from the first end, any length, then specified length. Any length means for the diameter 24, and then specified length for dia 30. That specified length is 100. So from this point, vertically 15, half of 30 up, 15, half of 30 down, right? And then extended for 100 mm. And 100 mm. Now this is the end of first rod, where the angle was 45, but in the disassembled view, in the assembled view, only 4 is mentioned. Only 4 means from this point additional 2 after 2. So extend it for 2 mm, then 2 down. Similarly, extend it for 2 mm and 2 up. This is the point, and join it like this. And for the open end, the diameter is 24, so from this point, half of 24, 12, extend it with fillet, and the radius of fillet will be total 30 minus 24 by 2. So the radius of the fillet is 3, with fillet radius 3, extend it for any suitable length, like this. Okay, again we have to extend these limits for its side view and for the second rod. So now, using limits of first rod, like this. Okay, so again similarly, mark ends of second rod, rod B, and for the length equals to 100 mm. This is 100, so this must be 100. Then with fillet radius 3, again extend it for suitable length. Like this. And then extend limits of dia 24 also for its side view. So for the side view, from this side, first circle of dia 24 and second circle of dia 30. So axis and two circles of dia 24 and 30. Now quarter slot width on the rod. So for rod, 37 from extreme left and 37 from extreme right is given to us. So from this end, 37. After 37, draw a vertical hidden line, and on the right rod again after 37, like this. And for the side view again, thickness is 8, so from this point, half of it, 4, from the center, half of it, 4, hidden. Last element, quarter. So for the quarter, total length is 100. So draw a vertical line of length equals to 100. Length is 100. 50 plus 50, total 100. And then on the upper end, the width is 32. On the lower end, from this point, the width is 28. So draw two lines perpendicular to first line, and the width is 32 and 28. And join them like this. Now for upper and lower curved ends, this is the radius. So this much as radius, this point as center, first arc. This point is second center, second arc, get the center, and this is center, this much is radius, upper curved part, similarly lower curved part. Now this is the front view of the quarter. for top view, for its top view, please project its limit. Limit means end edges like this, and the thickness is 8. So after suitable distance, top view, and in the top view the thickness is 8. And for this edge, please draw hidden line, because this part is hidden, right? And for curved portion, with any suitable radius, draw upper and lower curved part. Now we have all three elements, sleeve, rod A, rod B, and quarter with us. And the last task in this problem is to decide width of the quarter slot in sleeve and in rods. So as you can see in the assembled drawing, the width of the quarter is 32 and 28. It means the mean width in the middle. This is the center. So in the mean line, this width is average of 32 and 28. Average or mean of 32 and 28, 30. It means centrally the width of the quarter slot will be 30 plus the clearance. And from the given assembled view, the clearance is 3. So the mean width in the rod and in the sleeve will be mean width of the quarter 30 plus the clearance 3. So the width is 33. Now if you don't want to trouble yourself for the detail or for the disassembled view, then take 30 plus 3, 33, and draw vertical lines for the quarter slot in both rod and in the sleeve. But what about exact dimensions? Exact dimension means the width of the quarter is not constant throughout its length. It means in the sleeve with taper, the width will be slightly greater than the mean width. So width of the quarter slot in this height or in this fiber or in this layer will be greater than the mean width in the center, and width somewhere here will be less than this width. It means gradual reduction will be there in the quarter and similarly in the sleeve and in the rod. So for exact width of the quarter slot on the sleeve and on the rod, we have to mark different layers of sleeve and rod on the quarter, right? And please don't use dark pencil for this work. So from this point, this is the height of the first layer of the rod. So half of 30, 15. 15 up and 15 down. Similarly, from this center line, this is 30 and this is 66. So half of 66, 33. So what I'm doing here is 15 and then 18. No, it's 15 is 30 and total is 66. So half of 66, 33. Please don't show these numbers, this is for you only. So from the central axis, after 15, we have two limits, upper and lower limits of rod, and these limits are same for internal dia of sleeve. Then for external dia of sleeve, the diameter is 66, which we have to mark there. Now draw lines parallel to center line from these points like this. Okay, so now we have all four width of the quarter on the ends of rod and on the external ends or external diameter of the sleeve. Now this width is mean width of the quarter. This is width number one. This is width number two. Say this is width number three and say this is width number four. And all four, W1, W2, W3, W4 are not equal to W. W1 and W4 are greater than W and W2 and W3. These two widths are less than W. Now, for the quarter slot, we know that the clearance is constant throughout 3 mm. So, from this end, mean width is W, and on the rods, upper width is W1 and lower width is W2 for rod, right? So for rod, again, upper width is W1, mark W1 from this point, and W2 and draw hidden line joining them like this. Okay. Similarly on the sleeve, on this locus, on this line, the width is W1. So from this point, W1 plus 3. Okay, this is W1 plus 3, this is W2 plus 3. W1 plus 3 clearance, W plus 3 clearance, again W1 plus 3, W2 plus 3. Similarly, from this point, W1 plus 3 is the width. And for this layer, W4 plus 3. Here the width is W2 plus 3. And in this layer, W4 plus 3. These are different quarter slot width for the sleeve. And similarly, we have to repeat this process for the right side. So W4 plus 3, W1 plus 3, and here W2 plus 3, and W4 plus 3 with taper. So this is the exact calculation for the quarter slot width on sleeve and on rod. After marking width of the quarter slot, now next thing is dimensioning. So do proper dimensioning and dimensioning for all dimensions and all related edges for the center. To the last end. One more thing, we have to show the thickness of quarter slot in both. So for both the thickness is 8. And then hatching, so front view without sectional view, front view, so we don't have to hatch. Again for rods, we don't have to hatch anything in this part, but ends of the rod and for the circle which is representing die 24 is to be hatched. Okay, and then naming. So for naming, for sleeve, the heading is sleeve, then front view full in section, front view without section, or simply front elevation. Similarly for rod, so as per the problem statement, front elevation of the sleeve and side elevation viewing from left. For sleeve, then for rod A and rod B, front elevation of rod A, front elevation of rod B, then for quarter, front view and top view. Front view. Okay, and then we have scale used and projection symbol of first angle projection method. So write scale used 1:1 and symbol of first angle projection method. And last overall heading of the drawing, disassembled view of sleeve and quarter joint, or sleeve and quarter joint disassembled view, or details of sleeve and quarter joint. So this is all from my side. Please draw this problem on your sheet, starting from sleeve, then rod, draw front view and side view of the sleeve, then front view of rod A, rod B, then common side view, then quarter, then use these dimensions, these width of the quarter, and mark quarter slot on sleeve, left side and right side, and on the rod. And it's my request to you that please don't write these things in the sheet. This is for explanation only. So don't write W1, W2, W3 and all these things in your sheet. Just draw lines parallel to XY, get that width, mark them in sleeve and quarter. That's it. And if you have any doubt, any problem in any of the topic of engineering graphics class 11th or 12th or machine drawing, please write your comments in the comment section. Thank you.